In a world where spectators are increasingly discerning, multi-sport global sport events now need to deliver a multi-layered live experience. This is where Sport Presentation puts on its show.
Sport Presentation is the extra layer that will help everyone moving from a sport performance to a global experience in which the performance remains important, but you as a spectator participate fully.
It's not just announcing the results correctly. Sport Presentation refers to the way sport is presented inside the competition venues through the use of commentary, music, video, specialty lighting, and live entertainment. It has also recently evolved into the in-venue execution of a wider games engagement strategy and a seamless step within the spectator journey.
For the IOC, it's about the once-in-a-lifetime opportunity for spectators to engage with the games. For us, that means having not only an incredible experience inside the venue, but one that brings to life the Olympic Games and what is unique around the Olympic Games.
Sport Presentation is a complex and sophisticated production that needs to be timed and executed to the second. And it has many stakeholders. Sitting at the heart of the Olympic Games, athletes are the number one consideration.
Once we hear the music going inside the stadium, you know, that takes us to another level and we want to put on the best show. The crowd get involved also, and that helps us to run better. We see faster times.
Being able to walk out by yourself, being announced, looking up and kind of taking in the whole environment, that's super unique. Again, I think it just adds a good bit of drama.
Then you have the spectators, where the mission is to educate, engage, inspire and entertain.
I have to say that when spectators enjoy it, you can see the archers enjoy it much more. When the stadium, when the arena, when we have 2,000-3,000 people enjoying what is happening, you really should be there.
I think the atmosphere inside and in front of the venues is just great. I think everyone is happy, everyone is with a certain feeling of anxiety for the show or for the games that are coming up. So far, I really like it.
The engagement with the spectators is linked directly to the international federations, where there is a strong need to show the sport in its best light and a powerful opportunity to increase the fan base and promote post-games participation.
Since we introduced sport presentation, it's completely changed our sport. We have made matches much more dynamic, much more easy to understand and fun.
Everything has been built here to transform a casual spectator. Our goal was trying to transform these people in future consumer of volleyball. Future people either looking in television or starting playing volleyball.
Finally, we have the broadcasters, where the timings can have substantial consequences on their operation, and where the energy and reactions of the spectators can have a profound impact on the images that are sent around the world.
Sports presentation becomes increasingly important in the delivery of modern sports events. The worst thing that can happen to broadcasting is an empty venue or a venue with spectators who do not care or do not understand.
This means a lot of dialogue between broadcast operations, between sport presentation, between competition management, so everyone knows exactly what is happening and how it all fits together.
Sport presentation demands many hours of content. It calls for highly experienced people and highly sophisticated technology. These types of resources need to be effectively budgeted and planned for, as experienced staff and video production are the two biggest line items in a sport presentation budget.
It doesn't matter where people come from, they just have to be the best. They have to know the sport, they have to have maintained good relationships with the International Federation, they have to have a knowledge of broadcast and event producing.
Planning and cross-functional integration is time critical. And when it comes to creating the show, building a strong and early relationship with the international federations is crucial.
The international federations are focusing more and more about how their sports are presented in their own events. Using that experience specifically and bringing their sport to life is something that federations can use and bring to an organizing committee to help deliver that very special feeling around each sport in the Olympic Games.
You need to find a way to make sports presentations for sports which are very different, but it's important to find the common Olympic thread to do sports presentation, which may not necessarily be what you see in other independent competitions.
And so the show begins. From the time doors open, sport presentations should be up and running with music, video board programming, and entertainment. Spectators that are engaged can help produce an electrifying atmosphere for the athletes and broadcasters. It also provides a first vital opportunity to showcase a host country's culture on the field of play.
We have developed a narrative that was bringing the spectator from the moment in which they enter in the stadium, and we tell them that their role is crucial in running the show. They are not spectators, they are active participants.
The local flavor is what will make sport presentation a standard delivery to a games time delivery in Rio versus a games time delivery in London. And you want to make sure there is the same excitement, you want to make sure that the level of information is the same to the audience, with that local touch.
When the sport competitions take place, the sport presentation team is responsible for all announcements and commentary, music, lighting and video cues, ensuring coordination with the venue team and the International Federation.
It's extremely crucial that you have a great atmosphere at the range, at the field of play when you are performing. And of course it really helps when the spectators have fun. So it really is important how the sport is presented, if the spectator understands what's going on, what are the rules, what they can expect, and react accordingly.
When the competition ends, the responsibilities don't end with it. Sport presentation may also be responsible for the victory ceremonies and is often called upon by venue management to develop ways of slowing down spectator egress so that functions like transport and event services aren't overwhelmed by a large number of spectators exiting the venue all at once. Ultimately though, the role of sport presentation is more enduring than helping to deliver an exceptional live sporting experience.
I think that we have the ability to create more fans. We can continue to educate people and connect them to the athletes and to the sport. Then the sport continues to grow.